In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this word, O children of Israel, that the Lord pronounces over you, over the whole family that I brought up from the land of Egypt. You alone have I favored more than all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your crimes. Do two walk together unless they have agreed? Does a lion roar in the forest when it has no prey? Does a young lion cry out from its den unless it has seized something? Is a bird brought to earth by a snare when there is no lure for it? Does a snare spring up from the ground without catching anything? If the trumpet sounds in a city, will the people not be frightened? If evil befalls a city, has not the Lord caused it? Indeed, the Lord God does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. The lion roars, who will not be afraid? The Lord God speaks, who will not prophesy? I brought upon you such upheaval as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah. You were like a brand plucked from the fire, yet you returned not to me, says the Lord. So now I will deal with you in my own way, O Israel. And since I will deal thus with you, prepare to meet your God, O Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
At dawn, I bring my plea expectantly before you. For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
You hate all evildoers. You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful the Lord abhors.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
But I, because of your abundant mercy, will enter your house. I will worship at your holy temple in fear of you, O Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus got into a boat, his disciples followed him. Suddenly, a violent storm came up on the sea, so that the boat was being swamped by waves, but he was asleep. They came and woke him, saying, "Lord, save us, we are perishing." He said to them, "Why are you terrified, O you of little faith?" Then he got up, rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was great calm. The men were amazed and said, "What sort of man is this, whom even the winds and the sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, it is not always in good times that we've heard God speaking to humanity. He intervenes even when humanity is stubborn and disordered. Hindi lang sa oras ng kapayapaan, sa oras na magaganda o matitino ang tao, kundi sa oras ng kaguluhan at mas lalo't higit kung kailangan ng tao ng isang boses na magpapakalma at magpapatino sa kanila. The Lord spoke to the Israelites in our first reading in the midst of their sinfulness, in the midst of their affliction in front of God. God was never silenced by their faults. He was even more expressive even in such times of their crisis. And today we've heard this beautiful story of Jesus calming the sea and the storm. At dito po narinig din natin na nangibabaw ang boses ni Jesus para pakalmahin ang magulo at ang malakas na bagyo, at gayon din para mapakalma at mapanatag ang namamatay at humihinang pananampalataya ng kanyang mga alagad. God was never silenced by storms. He even stood out as the strongest voice in the midst of storms. It is not only, my dear brothers and sisters, in good times and in stable times that God can speak or make himself alive in our lives. He can be alive when humanity begins to fail. Hindi lang naman Diyos ang Diyos kapag panatag at masaya tayo. Diyos ay Diyos kahit sa mga magugulo at mahihirap na pagkakataon. Diyos ay Diyos kahit sa mga panahon na tayo din ay hinahampas ng hangin at ng bagyo. God is never silenced by storms. He will be the strongest and the loudest voice even in the midst of storms. At hindi po maaalis sa buhay natin itong parehas na magaganda o hindi magagandang mga karanasan. May masayang oras, may malungkot na oras. May maaayos na panahon, may magugulong panahon. May panahong panatag tayo, may panahong gulong-gulo tayo. But the Lord will not only speak and remind us during good times. He will be there as well to calm and pacify us when we are shaken down. This day, my dear brothers and sisters, we ask the Lord to speak to us. Hindi lang po may gulo sa labas, may gulo din tayo sa ating mga puso. He will be the best voice in our happiness. He will still be the best voice to silence the storm in our hearts. At napakagandang pabaon din po nito sa atin na kung ang Diyos nagwika sa mga panahong magugulo, sa mga panahong may nakita siyang malina, it is also an encouragement to us. Kapag may nakitang mali, magsalita, maging panatag para magkaroon ng kapayapaan, para magkaroon ng kapanatagan.
Please stand.
Even the wind and the sea obey the Son of God. With this in mind, we can pray confidently for calm in a turbulent world. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, grant us your peace.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That the Church, through its members, may be strong in faith, especially in facing the difficulties and challenges of our time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That sea travelers, sailors, fishermen, and those who earn their living from the sea may feel safe and secure. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That those who doubt their faith may be strengthened through the help and support of their friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That the disabled and those suffering from lingering illnesses may find inner peace in Christ's healing power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That the dead may experience the everlasting peace of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and for all the intentions offered in this Mass, and lift up to the Lord as well the prayers of our brothers and sisters joining us through online streaming and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
Heavenly Father, may the trials and troubles of life's storm-tossed waters purify us and bring lasting peace to our souls. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, the Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeem him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Let us go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
No.